brains in the back of me. I was searching for something, not sure who or what it was. Sometimes I get lonely, but no tears are leaving these eyes. Other searching for heaven. They gonna say I'm hotter, and some people can't stand a traveling man. All right.
A long way to go in this draft, but if you can lock up a few key positions here. Yeah, this is kind of a curious one if you ask me. The talent's certainly there. I'm just not sure that we'll see the best of him in a system like this. A.J. Green of Cincinnati is the choice here, and a good one it is. Green comes off four straight 1,000-yard seasons to begin his NFL career. Oh, no need to worry about this guy. Just plug him right into a starting role, and he'll be a massive upgrade. Where to now? Do you get yourself a big brute for the trenches, or someone who can really help you out at the playmaking type spot? The Cards have seen one player get taken already. Could another be about to join him?
She kept looking back like something was coming. Said we ain't slowing down, ain't stopping for nothing. My truck was shaking, my blood was pumping, but she was laughing. I about hit the brakes when we came around the corner. A mile of blue lights aimed and pointed. Whatever she had is what they wanted. It's all a little fuzzy after that.
All I remember. Some tough choices coming up right about now. Do you go after the best available player, or do you go after a position of need? Boy, the skills just leap out at you with this guy. He will be a very important part of this ball club.
Got away, but they found her. She missed the choppers. They were swirling around, for every couple of rounds. Off a couple, but they wouldn't back down. All I remember is sirens, blue lights flashing and driving, dirt lane passing and flying, tearing through the red lights, blowing through the stop signs. All I remember is sirens, ringing from the firing, one curve away from dying.
Oh, no question that this guy's going to grade out as a huge impact over what was there before.
We were all out of road and I knew she could tell, because she leaned across my lap and buckled my belt and kissed me on the cheek, said thanks for the help. Hold on, boy. Well, she yanked the wheel and I held my breath. We flipped so many times we should have been dead. And that's all I got. I just woke up here and that's it.
Now it's getting to the time of the draft where you really want to get lucky and hope somebody falls into your lap. And I think that pick comes to the surprise of no one. You had to figure they leaned that way if a player from that team became available.
For my music, for press and play, for all the stress that went into my songs, my love and hate. The most honest I could be with you to date is to say thank you, Shady, for letting me be me with no holes barred. Thank you for the chance to enhance this old car, this old job. And there's but two fine lines on a blank sheet, but so far, these two lines point directly to my home on the mothership sonar. I go par.
Where to now? Do you get yourself a big brute for the trenches, or someone who can really help you out at a playmaker type spot?
So hard from the sweat that I could take my clothes off, and the whole yard should sit back and shake.
And this is a big piece of the puzzle right here. Maybe a no-brainer, but a great pick regardless.
Letters, lettuce, green, money, loan, wolf packs in the cow's home. I'll keep making these cow bones. Yeah, you might have heard a dial tone, but I was on the other line when I hung up the phone. I send a postcard when I leave. I think about you when I dream. And when I'm up under the high beams, I reflect that shining. So you can feel the heat of light and life provide a son of Diane. You had to come a long way from Dixieland. Take my hand.
And there's a pick that'll certainly help. Maybe not an impact signing, but you're not going to hit a home run every round.
I'm talking low ride. 77 reveals, L dogs, nothing but them legs.
Sitting on glass in the front yard of the trailer park. One time for the single wide on the little crib. Two times if you know what it's like to live. With. Three times in a row you've been laid on the bridge. Four times before you did the same old, yeah. Baby done grown up, that beard like a grown up.
surprise there. But, hey, it's all about finding value where you can. And in their estimation, this was the best player available.
Easy break, land in the Bama, clean and safe. Dropped out of high school, recent, hey, I'm already ready. And they wonder why I speak this way. And you ain't never seen this place. Well, here's your American pie. It's a ditzy piece of cake.
Give kudos to the folks running this draft. They've targeted the guys they thought would provide the maximum value, and so far, it's been successful.
Begins today. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is Draft Champions. The 49ers interplay this afternoon, ready to see what they've got and how or if these pieces are gonna fit together. They'll match up here against the Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
And Galen Sturgis looks set now to kick it away. The 49ers are back deep, ready to return the kickoff. This game has officially begun. Brown's gonna test the coverage here. The returner made all kinds of mistakes, but give credit to the coverage team. They were down there in a hurry to make the stop. He is an impressive-looking prospect, this quarterback who leads the offense, Blake Bortles.
Yeah, he's a big old boy, as they would say, and he is country strong, no doubt about it, when you watch him play. And to me, that's his biggest strength, the fact that he's big, he has a presence on the field, and he is definitely the leader of the football team.
Tough starting field position here. Gets the handle here. Slashes to the left side. He's in the clear. The 40. The 30. The 20. The 10. Gonna take it home for the touchdown.
Anytime you see a long run for a touchdown, what you gotta look for is blocking downfield. Nice job by the block and a long touchdown run.
Hey,
interesting decision. I think we're going to see more two-point conversions in the league this year than ever before, because kicking an extra point from the 15-yard line, it's not a gimme anymore.
Todman will run this one out. Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. Starting at quarterback, the future of the franchise, Jameis Winston, the rookie out of Florida State.
Let's just go over the accolades. National championship, Heisman Trophy winner, first pick of the draft. Oh, my gosh, he's got it all. That's what the Tampa Bay Buccaneers hope. We'll see if he can get it done on the field.
First down at the 23. He runs with it right up the gut.
Jim, let's keep our eye on the defense. If they keep giving up runs like this, they're going to have to change what they're doing on the defensive side. Maybe bring another guy down in the box to stop those runs.
And it'll be second down and 6 after the running play on first down. Hand off. Jones, the one who made the big stop.
Well, but it's third long in a situation like this. I'm going to look at it from the defensive side. You know they're going to be careful, so make sure you come up and just make the tackle so they don't get those yards after the catch or a long run.
The Buccaneers have to get to the 33 for a first.
Third down and 11.
And Durham makes the catch.
The Buccaneers put themselves in a terrible situation. Third and long, but you know what? They got a lot of talent on the offensive side, and that was an awesome job of picking up that first down.
First down at the 48. Bethes all over that offense and brings him down.
Got to give the defense some credit. On first down, there's so many things the offense can do. They were ready for that play and they stopped it.
Press coverage all the way. Second down and 12. The Buccaneers now move the chains.
It takes really good corners to play a defense where you challenge the wide receivers and just play them man-to-man coverage. I don't think this defense has that kind of quality corners.
First down at the 36. Up the gut here. Here's a look at the offense. And this core group of wide receivers must find a way to get open today. The Buccaneers snap it at the 36. Looking at every option. Incomplete. That was Graham on the coverage. For this defense, one of the best corners in the league, can also be quite a factor in the return game. That would be Patrick Peterson, who was the 5th pick in the draft back in 2011.
Not many times you could just say all in one, but Patrick Peterson is truly one of those guys. There's nothing he can't do on the football field. One of the best players in the NFL.
Late in the first, and that's a big stop on third down to bring up a punt. And now they'll look to extend the lead.
Yeah, good job by the defense, but I'll say this for the offense. You've got to show more imagination if you want to have success, especially on third downs.
No good. An empty trip for the offense. Well, that would have gotten them right back into this game, but it looks like they'll go to the second quarter still struggling to get anything going in the right direction, Phil.
The bad news is they missed a field goal. The good thing is they got a long way to go, so you can still overcome the fact that you missed that field goal.
The 49ers take it from the 43. To Williams. A nice grab. No doubt he was going to hold on to that one. Young's there to take him down. The 49ers will attempt to carry over that momentum after that huge play before the end of the first. The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. To the ground. A tackle behind the line.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the first down play that time by the offense, and now they have a good situation.
Bortles set. Everybody emptied out for this snap. Looking across the middle. And that's a gain of 13 from inside the red zone. Bortles all by himself in the backfield for this snap. Gain of 8.
Good job that time by the offense. They pick up a first down inside the 20-yard line. Now we'll see if they can punch it in and get 7 points.
2-minute warning looms, and this may be the last play before it hits. Halftime is coming up, but first we reach the two-minute warning. We've got a defense out on that field trying to stand tall and keep this deficit as it is on the scoreboard. First and goal. Picks up about five. Second down here. Bortles, and he's in for the touchdown.
In today's game, you know, Jim, you always have to be alert in situations where the quarterback drops back to pass. You've got to think he might be able to run out of the pocket. And that time, the defense not alert for it. Nobody's there, and he scrambles in for a touchdown.
Going to be a penalty here. Has his man. Could have taken the one-point gimme. They went for the two, and they are turned away.
Defense.
Defense was trying to guess the snap count, and it cost them there. Try the fake. Put an additional 2 points on the board as they convert. He's put the ball on the tee and he's about to kick off. Todman will run this one out. Ball is out. Picking up the bumper. He's on the move.
Always hustle on the kick teams and always be alert. That football came loose. What a job by the kicking team falling on it and getting that fumble.
The Buccaneers will come out in the dive. First down at the 16. That's a gain of seven. About 90 seconds to go in the second quarter, and it's a second down play. Sherman's going to secure the handoff. Picks up eight here. The defense loading up on the line, getting set for this snap. He dives into the end zone for the score.
Ah, you just love it as a quarterback. You get down in there, and it's first to go, and you score. Now you don't have to sweat the fact that, man, what are we going to do if he gets the third down? You don't have to worry about it. Good run. Nice touchdown.
Away from the ball, there's a flag down on the field. Flag is out.
Delayed game, offense.
The 49ers with the PAT to come. Look at this. It's a fake. Hurts. The two-point try is denied. The 49ers lined up. Onside kick coming up. The receiving team has the recovery.
Thank you.
First down. Offense readying for the snap. Drop back, shotgun formation. Great pass, great catch, great control. That's his third catch of the day. The Buccaneers are going to burn the first of their three timeouts right here. They've got a first down with just a minute remaining before halftime. The Buccaneers come out in a bunch set. First and 10. Green, touchdown. Tampa Bay.
I give all the credit to the wide receiver here. What a route. Fooled the defender. He is wide open. Nice throw by the quarterback for the touchdown.
Add the extra point. The kick is good. The 49ers in kickoff return formation. Peterson's running this one out. Gets out past the 20 and brought down at the 24. Antonio Brown readying himself for this next possession. He's been less a part of their attack than is the norm for him. It hasn't cost them, though, as they've managed to grab the lead here in the first half.
Anytime you have a star wide receiver and he is not playing well, even though your team is winning, he feels like he's losing. So get him involved in the game. Give him some easy catches so he can pick his confidence up and he can be a part, and then you can go on and find a way to get this done.
First down at the 35. Bortles now going to leave the pocket and tuck it under. Two hands on the football and has the catch. That long gain sets them up here on this play. And it's AJ who hauls it in. Green's tackled down at the 31. The first half is complete. Larry Ridley ready to take things over back in the studios, and you're watching the NFL on EA Sports. All right, Larry, thank you for all of those updates, and now the teams are coming back onto the field, and we're about to get the second half started. Todman will run this one out. And he runs it out to about the 27 before he's taken down. The Buccaneers offense trots out onto the field looking to get into the end zone and see if they can turn the tide in this one, partner.
Well, the fact that they are losing this game so far, the sense of urgency is there on the offensive side. You know, you have many plays in that playbook. I think they need to try a few different ones here in the second half. Good job by the defense. They stopped the offense that time on first down. Now the defense is in a good situation.
Loss of five on the play. Second and long. Brings it in. And the tackle is made at the 35-yard line. That's his first reception today.
The drag route is a huge part of every offense now in the NFL. It's where the receiver starts on one side of the football, goes across the field, looking for those spots where he can catch it. And the quarterback that time threw it at the right time, right on target. Good yardage, just short of the first down.
Toss to the outside. And he's taken down, but not until he picks up the first.
Look at the defensive line. Everybody's spreading out. I think they're going to try to pressure the quarterback.
Now, cutting to the right side, looking for some open space.
Nice play call that time by the offensive coordinator coming with the counter run. And the defense being too aggressive. They're over-pursuing. So you do the little counter, go the opposite direction, and it works well.
Second down, three for the first. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
Window of opportunity is very small.
Quarterbacks with strong arms can still fire it in there. Nice throw right on target by the QB.
Winston's now completed four in a row. The Buccaneers snap it at the 41. That's a gain of six.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
The Buccaneers will take the snap from the 35. Chris Durham has the reception. He's brought down at the 25-yard line.
You know, when you throw the football like that down the field, you pick up a first down, now you can do anything you want on the offensive side, and you've got that defense guessing.
The Buccaneers will take the snap from the 25.
You got to give a lot of credit to the defense. They were all over the run that time, and they only give up a short gain.
The Buccaneers offense tries to continue some momentum, still possessing the football as the final quarter gets underway. The final quarter underway now with this snap. Brings it in along the sideline.
The best way to keep the other offense on the sidelines is just keep marching down the field and picking up those first downs. What a good job by the offense. When you get down in the red zone, the offensive coordinator's got to call a play that deceives the defense. Let's see if he can do it. His team is down. He needs a big play here. Coach's going to hear about this when the game is over. Running the football in a situation like this, late in the game, you're down multiple scores. You got to take some chances. You got to throw it, and you got to throw it down the field.
Second and goal from the three. And it's out of bounds, incomplete.
When you get third and goal, a lot of times it just comes down to who's willing to fight the hardest. We'll find out here in a second.
Third and goal at the three. Has it. Touchdown.
What a throw by the quarterback for a touchdown. It was just really nice. He threw it beautifully right on target. Touchdown.
Driving extra point is good. The Buccaneers getting ready to kick it away. Peterson's got it on the return. And the tackle's made right around the 25-yard line. The 49ers in quite a battle here in the fourth. The score's 22-14.
Wide to the left.
Got the first, and he's got some space.
A lot of people talk about time of possession. Sometimes it's overblown, but in a situation like this, where you're winning a close game in the second half, you want to control the tempo, control the clock, keep getting those first downs.
And now we reach the two-minute warning. We're coming out of the two-minute warning, and the offense is trying to run out the clock. Now first and 10. And he's going to pitch it here. Swallowed up behind the line of scrimmage. And they'll try to conserve time here with this timeout. The 49ers are at the line of scrimmage with a pair of backs split behind the quarterback. Slashes to the left side. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field. Coming to the line at the 48. Third down and 7. Trying to power his way right up the middle. There's the offense picking up another first down on third down. first down here after the run. Sherman's taking the handoff. That's a gain of six. And it's now second down and five after running it on first down. Trying to fight through right up the middle of the field. Young's there that time for the tackle.
Ken, the offensive coordinator's done a terrific job so far here today. He's got his team winning. You're in the red zone. Let's see how clever he's going to be on this call.
Tackle's made. Second down and 10. This play call is for the fullback. This will be the eighth play of this drive. Here's the quick toss. That picks up seven. The offense is still on the field here on fourth down, needing six for the first. Back at the line. They're going for it on fourth. Looking for some tape. Force it across for the touchdown. That touchdown might just wrap it up.
Yeah, it sure will, Jim. It's been an exciting game all day, and it to score late in the game like this, to put it away, it's time to celebrate a little on the sideline.
And a flag comes out. You talk about momentum. That turns into an 8-point trip, the touchdown and the two.
This offense and the head coach and the offensive coordinator, they're all aggressive. So, hey, well, it's not good enough just to get a touchdown. They want to get that extra point or 2 points. Nice job that time.
And the hands team does its job as the onside kick attempt is thwarted. The Buccaneers offense comes onto the field for a last play or two before this one's over. There's nothing they can do now to pull this one out for.
Yeah, listen, it's very tough to even get the courage or the energy to finish this game off in a situation like this because it's so disappointing. And I say to them, don't take any chances. Don't get hit again and just get off the field.
Second and 10. Jumps up and hauls it in. They're in the red zone, and we're in the late going, and they need to score as quickly as possible.
Well, this is where your offensive coordinator's got to call a play that gives you a chance to score quickly. Find something that goes up the seams or vertical, down the field, so the quarterback has the chance to get the score in one play.
He'll take the snap from the gun. And that pass is going out of bounds, incomplete. Following that incompletion, it sets up third and 10. One more snap and we can call it a day. Throws the pass. And off the mark on that short throw.
Defense crowding the line of scrimmage. Look out, this could be a blitz.
Winston's back in shotgun formation. And it's out of bounds, incomplete.
Well, Phil, I enjoyed watching the game with you. And how about a final thought about that victory?
Well, you know, Jim, I wish I could say the same that I enjoyed spending these last 3 hours with you. But that's just not the case. But, no, just kidding, of course. Nice win. They got to feel good about what they've done and celebrate a little tonight.
I think I'll see you next week, maybe.
For Phil Simms and all the crew at EA Sports, Jim Nance saying so long for now.